It is currently minus 7 degrees Celsius outside. We just had a storm last night. Visibility was about zero on the highway. They were not recommending you go out of town. Anyways, we got about a foot of snow in the parking lot. Anyways, took some pictures out the window and posted them on my Instagram if you want to go there. It's Axe Moose is the Instagram if you want to. Anyways, just watching the snow blow on the roof of the church right now. It's drifting away, little clouds of snow. It's kind of pretty to watch, but I don't want to be in it, but eventually, I'm going to have to be. Tuesday, I have an appointment, an important appointment. So, just have to be there. I've got a shout out for you, the Hungry ASMR artist. The link will be in the description. He does food eating ASMR videos. You betcha, you betcha. What else was there today? Windows 11, yes. If you force it to upgrade, they've got a new thing. There's an update that's about to come out. If you force it to upgrade before, without having the hardware stats that it wants to for you to upgrade to Windows 11, for example, mine doesn't meet the standards because my processor is way too old, and I don't have one of those security chips that it wants. I forget what they're called. TC something. I don't know what they're called, but anyways, it's a security chip that they want, and I don't have that on my nice old refurbished computer, so. It's not going to upgrade on its own, but I could force it to with a registry hack. But I don't want to. I don't want to brick my computer, basically, if it doesn't, if it's super not compatible and it just doesn't work, that's going to be a nightmare. So I'm not going to do that. but yeah, when you do that though, it's going to put a watermark on the desktop to remind you that it's incompatible. The hardware is incompatible. And on the landing page of the settings app. So, right? Quite frankly, if you forced it to upgrade with a registry hack, you're probably going to be pretty sure that you're not compatible with the with what they want you to have for hardware. So, because if you were compatible, you wouldn't have to do that. This is pointless. It's basically just trying to annoy people into not doing it. And going back to 10, it's just so silly, just so silly, completely silly. And of course, they're being widely criticized for doing this, but it's not the first time they've done something like this. So, one of the previous versions, I forget which one, they actually turned off a bunch of stuff. I think it was 10, actually, if you didn't if you had a shady upgrade, they turned off a bunch of stuff. So the idea that you can run an operating system without registering it in modern times, it was ridiculous in the first place. So the idea that they would turn off a bunch of features and still let you use it is ridiculous in itself. But yeah. But when it's a free upgrade. A free upgrade. If you have Windows 10 and it's a free upgrade, and people force it to upgrade, you should just Leave them alone. It's on them. It evidently warns you. I've never seen it done, so it evidently warns you that it's incompatible hardware. So when you're doing it, so that should be enough for people to realize, hey. But no, they want you to forever be looking at this watermark instead. The chances of me ever having a computer that's going to run Windows 11 is pretty slim. So that means I'm going to end up after 2025, I'm going to end up having a computer that has a dead operating system on it, or an obsoleted operating system on it. I know people that ran 7 long after its expiry date, so it's not impossible to do, but you get nags on the browsers and stuff like that, where it tells you that this cannot be updated and stuff like that. So that's rather annoying to have happen, but I'm just not gonna have $1,500, $2,000 for a computer, a new computer that has modern hardware. I'm just not ever in my life. So, even buying the parts would be and putting it together myself would be well beyond my means ever. So, unless they start having refurbished computers for a reasonable price range that are Windows 11 compatible, it's not going to happen. So. I've been looking at the refurbished models around, and none of them have anywhere close to the processors and the new the processors that they want you to have. There's this minimum standard for how old they are and whatnot, and a lot of them don't have the that chip that it wants. So, And from what I've been reading, there's really been no problems with almost anybody at all with forcing it to upgrade. It's been running smoothly, so it's just a pointless nag, basically. That's all it is. It's a nag. I've had software in the past that I was going to use temporarily, and I didn't want to buy it, but it was nagware, and every time you turned it on, it nagged you to buy the full version. And I didn't need the features of the full version. I just needed a few features and that were on the free version. And but there was that nag every time. I think I only used it for a couple of weeks anyways, and then uninstalled it. So yeah. You betcha, you betcha. And then there's obsoleted software. I've got a couple of the things saved in my cloud and stuff and on my hard drives that are obsoleted software that I use rather regularly, and they work extremely well for what I want to do with them. Virtual Photographer, for example, is no longer available from the website that it used to be available from. In fact, I think the website's gone, but yeah, it's just no longer available anywhere, and except for shady download sites that I wouldn't trust if you paid me. So, having a copy of that is a nice thing because it was free in the first place. But it was quite useful for filtering photographs. It's not that fun face filter crap, like Instagram and all that, or not Instagram, TikTok and all that stuff. It just changes the colors and it changes the histogram and stuff like that on the to make the photo look different or better or artistic, It's got a whole bunch of settings that are pretty good, and I got a package of stuff that makes it have way more settings. So, yeah, it's kind of nice. Anyways, I'm gonna have my coffee. Yippers, then I'm gonna watch my music feed, and I'm going to catch up on that. I watched six movies yesterday. Okay, I watched three. I realized that I had watched three of them before. So I didn't actually watch them. I just skimmed through them to familiarize myself with them. Have a good one.